And now what about us, the people? We don't want war, here or in Germany. And that's one of the hopeful features of the situation. But we have to prepare for it as never before. We have to convince Hitler that if he goes on trying to wipe countries off the map of Europe, we shall fight. And we have to convince the German people that if for the time being they're being encircled, it is only because their government is a threat to all peace-loving nations. To do that, we must make great sacrifices and, above all, reach quick and courageous decisions. I don't believe myself that the nation will be prepared to make those sacrifices unless we have a real national government and not one which has allowed us to drift into the present situation. We have now taken the initiative by returning to the old policy of the League of Nations. I believe it will be understood by the German people as distinct from the Nazi Party. I hope it will lead to peace. In any case, we shall have done all that is humanly possible. The last word and the last responsibility will still rest with Adolf Hitler.
We are preparing to put into the field, in the event of war in a European theater, a force of no less than 19 divisions. But each one of these divisions will be stronger than the divisions were in 1914, when Mr. Holbein had available a force of 6 divisions. It is mechanization which is adding to the strength of our army. It is the modern armament which is adding to its hitting power. But we are not only mechanizing our army, we are doing something else which pleases me much more. We are humanizing it as well. So the soldier is not only getting better equipment as a fighter, he is getting better conditions as a man.